What is up, world? I am Keith Urizarian. This is On the Fly. Mike Kelly will be joining us in a bit to break down the biggest matchups on the slate for Thursday. Make sure you stay with us for the next hour as we get you caught up on the games with major East and West wildcard race implications. But first, we start in Boston, where the Rangers were taking on the Bruins. Both teams fighting to win their divisions, but also vying for the number one seed in the East. With the Bees currently having a 3-point lead over the Blue Shirts, but New York a game in hand. Let's head out to TD Garden, where it's all coming back to me now. You'll see why.
It's an honor and a pleasure to introduce Celine Dion, who's going to do starting lineup. She has her two songs with her.
I know you're going to play. Here we go. You make me hungry. Grizzy. Ooh. Bulldog.
That man, the head coach of the New York Rangers, Peter Laviolette, coaching in his 1,500th career game. Bruins power play.
Quick makes a great stick save, and Frederick had two chances. DeBrusk scores!
Picking up that loose puck, doesn't panic initially, and he rips a low shot glove side.
Matt Grizzly, the defenseman carrying it in deep. Centers for Marchand, save by Quick.
And another excellent save by Jonathan Quick.
That's a beauty.
It sure is.
15:56, the timely penalty to Chris Kreider. On the boards it goes, it shot stopped by Quick. Rizzo had that chance.
It's a good save, and then Frederick was able to find the loose puck for a shot. For Swayman, it was a fairly easy first period.
Centers across, comes to Panarin, he scores! They kept at it, and Artemi Panarin scores his 39th goal of the season, 95 points. Every goal Artemi Panarin scores creates a new career high. What a season that man is having.
Roslovic.
Roslovic able to one-time that puck that was bouncing and spinning, and that can be difficult, but Swayman able to make the save.
Lindholm plays it back to Chattenkirk. Game tied 1-1 with 30 seconds to go. That deflected! Rangers score!
Panarin's going to get the goal, Sam.
Panarin makes it 2-1 as it deflected in off of Bruin.
DeBrusk came back trying to prevent a pass from getting to the other side, and it goes off of him and in.
McAvoy tries the short side, a shoulder save by Quick. Boqvist in front, Marchand, and Brazo muscles the puck over the line. Brazo's,
I mean, he's almost at the goal line when he scores this goal. From that look, it sure looks like a good goal.
Drops it off to Sabanich, Andrews, Gustafson to Fox. Moving in, shooting, he scores! And a Fox rips one by Jeremy Swayman, and the Rangers regain the lead. It's 3-2.
Boy, what a shot.
And that goal is Adam Fox's career high 13th. Six skaters on for Boston. Kreider passed to Sabanich to the empty net. He scores! With 2:03 remaining, the Rangers have a two-goal lead. Lifted out by Fox.
Here
comes that
anyway.
Breakaway. Panarin! It's a hat trick for Artemi Panarin! Ranger fans sending the hats out onto the Boston ice. 391 career wins for Jonathan Quick.
This is a tough building to win in. It's a great hockey team we're playing against. And they came out hard. I felt like slowly kind of took over the game, and, you know, we played a great second and third. We kind of controlled the pace there, and that's what it takes to win the games.
Big game like this, and he really stepped up. I thought everybody did. He's going to get the noise around it because he scored three, but there's a lot of guys that played a heck of a game tonight. I thought Foxy on the back end tonight was brilliant, so good stuff.
And Jonathan Quick did make 24 saves on 26 shots in the Rangers' victory on Thursday, earning win number 391 in his career, putting him in a tie with Ryan Miller for the most wins among U.S.-born goaltenders in NHL history. Speaking of history, he always makes history every time he's on the airwaves. Mike Kelly joins us now. And, Akels, I should start with Celine Dion. Like, when you talk about rock stars, she was, like, cool as cool could be in the pregame meeting with the team, huh?
Absolutely. Look, I'm coming to you from Montreal, Quebec here. She is a huge deal up where I live. And there's NHL locker rooms. There have been. There still is to this day that have Celine on the playlist. So she's like, the players know who she is. She's awesome.
Yep, my heart will go on. So as valuable as, and we got to get to hockey now, Jonathan Quick has been as a backup netminder, Artemi Panarin has been absolutely vital for this Rangers squad. I remember earlier in the year talking about how much he was shooting the puck now. He continues to improve on a career year. Kells, what are you enjoying about seeing him this year?
You nailed it, I think. The dual threat, right? He's always been a pass-first guy. Still is a pass-first guy, but, man, he is shooting the puck a lot more. He's scoring more. The goals in this game were kind of funny. I mean, you get a little wrist shot that finds a way through. You get another one that banks in off Jake DeBrusk and an empty netter. But the fact remains, I mean, Artemi Panarin is one of those rare play-driving wingers who drives a line by himself, really is the main catalyst on his line. It's the highest scoring line with Trocheck and Lafreniere in the NHL at 5-on-5, and he's a massive reason why. And he has obliterated his career high in a lot of really key shooting areas. Shots on goal, slot shots, goals, all career highs. He's top 10 in the league in shots and goals. Not something that you would think, you know, years past with the Breadman being mainly a setup guy.
You know what's fun is you get to this point in the season, I think there are things you know, right? We know the Rangers will be one of the top seeds in the East, but then there's the great unknown. How deep of a run do you think this team could make?
Look, they're good. Carolina's really good too in their division, and that's going to be tough. But this is a game to me that could be a template for how the New York Rangers need to play to win in the playoffs, to win against elite teams. And Peter Laviolette touched on it. He said Panarin's going to get the noise because of the hat trick, but so many guys played so well. They checked so well in this game. That's a denied entry right there that leads to a rush up the ice that leads to a penalty. And now you go on the power play. Their checking details in this game were really, really good. And that's a concern I've always had about this Rangers team is can they check the elite teams in the league well enough? They're second last in the league in how much offense they give up off the rush. And this is a game where Boston got really jammed up at the blue line and the Rangers didn't give them much on their entries, forcing them to ice pucks and just not allow them to get set up in the offensive zone, get the middle of the ice. The Bruins, on average, gain the offensive zone successfully on 53% of their entries at 5-on-5. That number was under 40% in this game against the Rangers. So, you know, it's getting into the minutia a little bit, I know, but again, it's things like that, that like if the Rangers play like this, that's a template for them to be successful when it really matters most.
Clearly two of the best teams in the league. Mike, do not go anywhere. We're going to chat in just a few, but first we jump back into the highlights with the Flyers taking on the Canes in Carolina.
Flyers coming off a big win over Toronto, and yet they're still without some key people. Sean Couturier again. Flyers down 3-2. Here's Frost moving up. Frost dangles to the back end of the forehand. It didn't go. Rebound. He stopped. Another rebound. They score.
Here's the replay right here. Coming through the neutral zone. Watch Konechny. Watch his feet.
Skate.
That's
offside.
It's offside.
After coach's challenge, it was determined that the play was offside. There is no goal.
This is a huge early break for the Hurricanes.
Oh, a turnover by Harrison.
And a save by Harrison. He robs Lemieux, who was pretty much counting that one. Sam Harrison makes the mistake in the giveaway and then makes up for it in a big way. Right now it plays out as Nature's wraparound try. It did not go. A diving play made by Johnson.
Johnson with the desperation and read dives across and saves a goal. Terrific play there by Johnson.
Flyers going up against the best second period team in the NHL. Trying to jab this one through. It's a turnover. And here's Natchez. Dangerous rush here. Natchez back. Robbie at the shot and they score.
Party, party. Oh, pick like JW on the golf course when he's making a putt from long range for Martinuk. The red hot Jordan Martinuk.
It's a perfectly placed shot by Martinuk. A guy you wouldn't expect to bury pucks like that. It was a good shot.
Here's Lawton trying to get it right back and he does. Scott Lawton beating Anderson and an immediate response from the Flyers and it's tied at one. 25 seconds later, that is immediate.
And we said both teams play fast, and when the Flyers are playing their best hockey, they transition pucks out of their zone quickly. A puck battle won that leads to this opportunity, and
Aho has it. Aho into the middle, a big blast, and they score. Jalen Chatfield blowing it by Harrison. It's 2-1 Carolina.
Feed here to Chatfield, who's coming late. Enough time and space for him to let go the one-timer. The Hurricanes have the one-goal lead once again.
Start of the third period, 2-1 for the Hurricanes.
Plays it back to Konechny. Off of the right side, Zanine back for Konechny. Save, Anderson. Beautiful rush, and there is Svechnikov taking a penalty. Flyers should probably just let that go, because I think they'll get a power play if they don't even it up.
Exactly, it's just going to be Svechnikov. You got to be disciplined.
Tippett gets it back, lays it off for Konechny. Back to Tippett, couldn't get shut up. Now between legs, it matches to Konechny, and he scores! Travis Konechny picks up the garbage in front. And he knew what to do with it. And this game is tied at 2.
Gets it down low, through the legs, finds Konechny. You kidding me? That is an unbelievable play by Frost.
We get more hockey here. 2-2, 1 point in the bag for the Flyers. We'll see if they can get another one. It's 3-on-3 overtime. Comes at you.
Oh, missed coverage.
Little cross and drop. Anytime you can cross and get everyone mixed up. Now it's Burns and Jarvis on a 2-on-1. The two friends coming in. Burns has it to Jarvis. Scores!
Five games, and to settle this shame on his natural side.
Hurricanes get out of here with 2 points, but an important point for the Flyers.
Second game in a week in this winning streak that Carolina's going to say, we didn't play our best, but found a way to win. That's a great hockey team to be able to do that.
Yeah, just sticking with it. Freddie played great again. And I mean, we didn't play our best, but those are big 2 points. Yeah, I mean, he gave me a brutal pass, but we're gonna forget that. He was great. I mean, it was sweet to get that with him, and something I'll remember for a while. Yeah, it's just grinding, just sticking with it. We know the team we have in our room, and never losing hope, never losing our energy. So we got to bring it tomorrow.
Well, just yeah, obviously that's a nice play by Burns and Jarvie and OT to get. Whenever you get odd man rushes in OT, it usually you're hoping that you can end it. Obviously, the third wasn't what we wanted to come out with. I felt like we were on our heels a little bit to start and kind of got a little bit of traction. And then you got to give them some credit. Like they're playing desperate hockey too, so they're going to come at us. And just learn from it, try and manage the puck a little better, and move on tomorrow night.
Absolutely blazing hot. Seth Jarvis on fire. Netted the overtime game winner on Thursday. Extended his goal streak to 5 consecutive games in that span. 6 tallies, 4 of which are game winners. That is awesome. Hey, speaking of awesome, Mike is back, and the Canes pull it off in overtime. Certainly an eventful extra session for Brent Burns. What did you see from him?
It was. I mean, this is one of those things where like it can go sideways really quick, or you can be the hero really quick. And in about a 10-second span, Brent Burns was involved in a lot of different action. Like, he's tracking here. It's probably a switch that should happen. Burns doesn't take the guy coming into the middle of the slot, and that's a wide open shot that ends up going wide. But now he's got a great defensive stick. That puck gets through. It's a breakaway for Philly. But Burns gets his stick on it. He's a big, rangy guy. And now you go up the ice. You got a forward playing defense on a 2-on-1. And you sauce over a bit of grenade, yeah, in the words of Seth Jarvis. I think it was right on his tape. 20-plus minutes. This guy's played forever, and he just continues to be an impact player for Carolina.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. All right, on the other side, the Flyers get a point, and they're still holding on to that third spot in the Metro. If the season ended today, it doesn't. But if it did, they would meet up with the Canes in the first round, and you thought this was a good matchup, except for maybe a couple of costly turnovers?
Yeah, exactly. I thought by and large, Philly played them really well. And that's tough to do against this Carolina Hurricanes team, as we know. There were really 2 plays, and they were both the goals. Turnover here at the offensive blue line. You can't get a puck in deep, and it leads into an odd man the other way. Trailer, Martinuk goes bar down. And then again, don't get it deep. Turnover at the offensive blue line. And now Carolina's attacking. The Hurricanes are not a rush team, really, but they can transition the puck and score off turnovers, and that's what they did. Other than that, Philly played them pretty well. The shots were even. They had more of the quality shots. They did what Philly does, which is generate a lot off the rush and a lot off the counterattack. It was just 2 plays that Carolina's going to beat you on, and you have to know when you're playing the Hurricanes, there's not a team in the league that defends its blue line better than Carolina. You got to get those pucks deep, as they say, going into the playoffs. But Philly should be, you know, reasonably happy with that effort against a very good team.
You nailed it, as you always do. Thanks a lot, Kels. Back to you in just a few. But back to highlights we go as well, where the Preds were looking to make history against the Panthers.
It is controlled to Yossi. He's got room. He toe drags to the backhand. Throws it out in front. And there, with the stick, was Tarasenko to clear the slot, as it was a wide open cage if Nashville could have found the puck. What a play by Yossi.
And now we got a tilt.
Just as the puck drops, Zucker and Cousins.
And Zucker does some MMA training in Vegas in the offseason, so let's see if he can put some of those octagon skills to good use as he gets some lefts going. Cousins, oh, that's a spirited tilt down here in South Florida to start it off.
The Panthers break out. Here's Sam Bennett across the line. Creates some room. Nice back check, though, by Forsberg to spring Nyquist. Comes across the line. O'Reilly on his right. Saucer pass. Oh, oh, what a save! Steals one away from O'Reilly. You're not going to see a better save than that. Forsberg with a backhander. Loose in the blue paint for Bobrovsky. Searches for it. Score! The hard work ends up paying off for the Predators. It looked like Nyquist got the final touch. Nashville on the board as they have dominated the first period and have earned a 1-0 lead. It's going to be a power play for Nashville, and they will control here. They win a scrambling puck. Floating one towards the net. Score! Put it down low. It was tipped, it looked like, maybe by Forsberg in front. A power play goal for the Predators as Forsberg tips it home, and it's 2-0 Nashville. Things change quickly in this league if you have a bad couple of weeks.
So true.
Long wrist shot blocked before it got through. Toe drag. Oh, what a save by Lankinen. He robbed Rodriguez.
Rodriguez scoops it, and Kevin Lankinen stretching all the way out.
Rodriguez with speed on Carrier. Waits for help. Carrier on the follow-through took the step. Right off the bench. Save made by Lankinen a couple of times.
Lankinen coming up big once again as he's able to sort this one out.
To his left to Verhaeghe. Throws one out in front. Oh, Nechichuk. Save made by Lankinen. And he got another.
Kevin Lankinen stretching out. Big time stop there.
Nyquist gloves it down. 5:45 to go. Out in front. Stopped by Bobrovsky. It is available. The rebound. Score! Again, a hard-working goal for the Nashville Predators. And they now have a 3-0 lead.
Gus Nyquist, that's 20 on the season in your career-high season.
And not only is this a road win against a top-notch team for the Nashville Predators, but it is the third career shutout and the first this year for Kevin Lankinen.
I wasn't really thinking about any of those things, to be honest with you. You know, we just found something real good here as a team. And obviously, myself, been playing with Factor and Phil here for basically the whole season and seem to be working well. So it's been awesome playing with those guys, and a lot of credit to them.
You guys say I'm 34. I still feel young out there. You know, when I came in the Detroit system, my first few years, 34 seemed to be pretty young, to be honest with you, on that team. The game's developed. It's gotten a lot faster. It's a lot more skill in the game, I think it's an exciting game out there.
Get your history here. Nashville has made history with the win over the Panthers. The Predators extend their current point streak to a whopping 16 straight games, which is now the longest point streak in a single season in franchise history. The final wildcard spot in the East is still very much up for grabs, and three of the key contenders were all in action Thursday night. We'll catch you up on who is inching closer and who is losing ground in this tight race right after the break.
Serious Eastern Conference playoff picture implications here.
Those teams are leaking oil.
Detroit has to play better defensive hockey.
The Islanders need to get back on track.
They're going head to head. The gravity is ridiculous.
He scores!
That was as good as I've ever seen.
Detroit can be deadly when a team gets their captain back.
Miller Larkin! He scores!
If ever there were an understatement, it would be, this is an important game.
They're battling for the wild card spot.
It will come right down to the wire.
Back here on the fly, Kells, the battle for the final wildcard spot in the East has featured a lot of twists and turns. We had a big one on Thursday night between the Isles and the Red Wings, and you and the Sport Logic crew crunched the numbers of what the matchup actually meant for each team to get into the playoffs. So what did you find?
Yeah, this is huge. Obviously, this is a huge matchup. And we're looking at things like, you know, games remaining, strength of schedule, all these things that go into playoff probabilities. And just from the Islanders' standpoint, you know, if they win this game, they'll go from just under 20% chance of making the playoffs going in, where Detroit's at 40, to basically leveling the playing field with the Red Wings, which is significant. I mean, that's really changing things in your favor. And considering New York's schedule coming up this weekend and next week, one of those games you look at and you're like, maybe this is the one they have to actually have a shot here.
I'm going to ask you a question, but then I'm going to answer it, so you can just smile and nod. Would you like to see the highlights? Yes, you do. Let's get out to some action. Little Caesars Arena for the Isles and the Red Wings.
There's Ryan Pulock to the side of the net. Missed it. Bo Horvat had the open goal, didn't have the angle, and the puck fluttered wide of the cage.
Oh, he had all kinds of time. He could have turned around, got it on his backhand.
Look out, here's Fisher. Oh. He's in the clear. Christian Fisher all alone. He scores! What a roll! 3 goals the past 4 games for Christian Fisher.
Well, it's that line again. Fisher, Rasmussen, and Pop. He goes 5-hole. To move it along for McLean. Now for Riley up on the rush. Scores! Riley gets one through Reimer. And the Islanders come right back to tie it at one.
But you know what? What makes the whole play is he jumps up on it. Good out by Cizikas and then a quick pass all the way across. Riley coming up quick.
Trot in front. Fisher up in for two. Fisher had a great chance, and the rebound slid off the goaltender to his right, and right in front of Kopp, who just pulled it to the front in the crease and slapped it in.
Jefferson dumps it to the corner. After it goes to Brinkett, wide open Larkin. He scores! Dylan Larkin from the Brinkett. It's 3-1.
No handle on that puck for Dylan Larkin. A bullet. Sorokin down. No mistake in that one. 27th of the year.
Rasmussen drives to the net. Dropped it back for Fisher. Hit a body in front. Kopp, he scores! He's got two! And it's 4-1! This line has done it again! DeBrincat carries in with Kane. DeBrincat to Kane. He scores! Patrick Kane on a 6-game point streak now.
The T DeBrincat with a little look. Sort of fakes the shot, freezes the goaltender. No problem for 88 again.
Now Ryan Pulock. 10.5 to go here in the third. Pulock fires. Reimer scores. J.G. Pageot able to find that loose puck. And the Islanders get one on the power play.
That one squirted through Reimer's legs too, I think, and came out. This time Pageot was right there, and he hammered it into the net.
4:30. Scores. Tipped in front on a Barzal shot. And deflected in front of the net.
Short side, I don't know what it went off, whether it was an Islander or a Red Wing.
Alec Wasson, Raymond ahead, empty net for Dylan Larkin. He scores! 6-3! As the Red Wings get a huge 2 points on the New York Islanders. Just what they set out to do.
Maybe shame on our group, shame on the staff, not getting more out of the group with Dylan out, but it's just... it's unbelievable just the difference when everyone is slotted where they should be. So quality win, great team win. We took care of business at home here. That's 3 straight wins on the road. And it's even more important with the type of road trip we have ahead of us.
I know the name of the game is winning, but I will say this. Our guys played a really good game. I mean, you played this game again, and I'm pretty sure we would win it. They had all the reason in the world to quit, and no one does, and it showed the character of our guys. It's too bad, because tonight we didn't get rewarded. We deserve a lot better than what we got.
Yeah, tough one for the Isles. The Red Wings, they might have gotten their captain back on Thursday, but it was the team's third line that showed up in that game against the Islanders. The trio would combine for 7 points on the evening. Andrew Kopp, 2 goals. Christian Fisher recording a 3-point night. Kells, the third line was so good for the Wings, but yeah, the captain, he stole the show in his return. He was awesome.
Yeah, you know what? Derek Lalonde talked about what he means in terms of slotting everybody in the right spot. That's a huge thing. Probably the most important when you get Dylan Larkin back. I'm going to throw another thing at you, though. The swagger that Dylan Larkin brings to this lineup. I mean, he had a lot of good looks in this game. Ends up getting the 2 goals. That one tee was an absolute bomb. Gets the empty netter as well. But he has a certain swagger when he's on the ice. He's their most skilled forward. He's a really good two-way centerman. And there's just something about watching him play and that swagger that he brings to this lineup. And you can tell the other guys feed off that as well. They are a complete team, a more complete team anyways, when he's in the lineup. And we talked about those playoff odds coming in if the Islanders had won. Well, you look at where they are now, 51% to get into the playoffs for Detroit, less than 10% for the New York Islanders. I have a feeling that this game may be the one we look back at and say that was the nail in the coffin for the New York Islanders season.
Larkin giving them swagger. Kel's going to be back with us. He's got to go, you know, swag surfing now. To the highlights, Connor McDavid and the Oilers welcomed in the Sabres, who are looking to keep pace in the East wild card race.
Thompson will leave it on the wall. Byram and Thompson combining to keep Edmonton in the zone. And here's a nice play to the front of the net. Scores! What a pass from Alex Tuch across to J.J. Paterka. And the Sabres are on the board early. They lead it 1-0.
Lumbering through the neutral zone, play ruled onside. Power hits the trailer, Dahlin loads and fires and scores. 2-0, Rasmus Dahlin. But I want another look at that zone entry.
Yeah, you come across the line, it's a quick little move across the line, and they are going to challenge this one, obviously, and
it's going to come off.
It's going to come off,
hey, can you please reset the clock to 7:29? The play was offside, no goal.
There you go. Yeah. Makes a nice move at the line. Tried to feed it to the slot. It does get their scores. Victor Olofsson backing up as that puck eventually found him in the slot. Turned and let that one kind of just whip towards Skinner, and it beat him. So it's 2-0 Buffalo after all now with 3:26 remaining in the opening period.
Edmonton will finish the period on a power play. Nugent Hopkins, one-timer to save it.
And they finally have foiled Luukkonen and got on the board. It's a one-goal game.
McDavid triggers a 2-on-1. Ekholm and Evander Kane. Ekholm to shoot. Scores! This game is tied! Matthias Ekholm whistles one over the left shoulder. 2-2.
There's the aggressive play on Dahlin. He doesn't play it soundly. A Bouchard one-out left pass to McDavid. And then Ekholm activates with Kane.
Clifton, great play to jump down the right side. In front, shot scores! Connor Clifton won't get the goal. J.J. Paterka, his second of the night. But 75 made the play to make that goal happen.
And it ends up going 5-hole. Oh, here's a failed clear and a bad one. Giving Edmonton a second look and a shot by Ekholm. A flopped clear leads to the equalizer. 3-all. Stetcher. Darnell Nurse. Jimmy shoots. Scores! What a play! Drysdale makes certain to get it in deep. McDavid, beautiful play against Cousins. Center can't jump. Second and second of the night. The effort by McDavid creates Ivan's 48. And it's lights out for Buffalo and Rogers.
Still to come, with the Blues hot on their heels, the defending Stanley Cup champs welcome the Kraken to Sin City. See if the Golden Knights can pad their lead for the final wild card spot in the West. Next. Welcome back to On the Fly. Out to Sin City we go, where the Golden Knights welcome the Kraken on Thursday night.
March Madness has hit Las Vegas in a big way. Stanley Cup playoffs start less than a month from tonight. And there is an outside chance now that defending Stanley Cup champs might not be participating in this tournament. Vegas right back. Inside the net, there's in. Jack Eichel. The touch of the side of the cage. Barstow's just throwing that to the front of the net, trying to maybe bank this on off of Grubauer's leg. Eichel's there to bang it in. His 22nd of the year. 1-0 Vegas. High stick is going to be called, and Seattle's going to go to the power play. With 7:58 to go in the third, trailing by a goal. With third in the Pacific. The third, score! The shot from the point by Riker Evans tipped in front, and there it is. It's a 1-1 hockey game. Now with speed, here's Waugh, has a chance now. This puck squeaks through, but it's all Howden. Power move to the net, uses his right leg to make sure the defender can't get to the puck. And it's Kolesar driving that back door. Huge goal for Vegas, 2-1.
Again, 5-on-5, even the cracking of a man on the puck. McCann fits it off, side of the net, and he's stopped with a crease. Matty Beniers had a golden opportunity to tie this game in the blue. What a chance. And now the empty net. Vegas Golden Knights.
Here they come, though. Bapherson right on goal. And a save by Hofer. Center. And Hofer made that save.
What a great save there by Joel Hofer. Readjusted and got the pad out just in time. That's the main thing. Under control.
And then Giroux with lots of time. Whips it on to center. Stutzla with it. And in a goal. And what a save by Hofer. Great move by Stutzla.
And John, as you know, a lot of times those big saves lead into other opportunities.
And the rookie Kessel walks in. Kyrou with it, shoots a rebound. They score! Saad gets the rebound! And the Blues have taken a 1-0 lead.
Well, you get rewarded by being at the blue paint, that's for sure. A lot of Blues players finding that out here recently. Shot there by Kyrou, rebound sitting there. Brännström doesn't do his job in taking care of Brandon Saad.
Blues at the line, here's Saad. And then Kyrou in front, Parayko shoots, and he scores! Parayko in for the point, and the Blues another goal, and they enjoy a 2-0 lead.
Well, right on cue there, John. Cole Parayko does a great job of sneaking in, but that puck literally goes through Forsberg into the net.
That pass to center ice picked off by Joseph. Wade comes with a stop check, and Kessel, a considering pass for Tavlich, scores! A sweet feed by Matthew Joseph to Kessel, and Ottawa's on the board, down one. What a pass.
Watch his eyes here. He's going with a no-looker. He's trying to be cute there, getting it to neighbors, but Joseph was not sold, did not get out of his lane.
Paul, backhander by Shen. Rebound comes right in front. In the goal crease. Rebound. A score. Jake Neighbors, I believe, gets the second attempt. And a huge goal to make it 3-1.
No surprise that guys who go to the blue paint get rewarded. Brandon Saad got rewarded earlier tonight. Jake Neighbors, who has made his living in that blue paint this season, finds himself with another one.
And it stays in. Stutzla right in front. What a save on Tkachuk by Hofer. Call the cops.
Yeah, I'd be shaking my head too, because most goaltenders aren't making that save.
In the opening seconds of the third period, Ottawa's getting a power play. Shabbat. Back around is Giroux. Simmons, a pinto with a chip. Rebound, score!
Hofer almost got that with a stick, or that would have been too much to bear, but Kubalik out of the power play gets Ottawa back within one.
Kyrou, Berchenko in front, Bandon shot. Kyrou turns, he scores! Kyrou, spinorama goal, a huge one, and the Blues are back on top again by two.
That is exactly what Jordan Kyrou can provide to this Blues team.
And the Blues with it, Neighbors, empty netter! And Jake Neighbors, his second goal tonight.
The Blues have been on a roll lately. Over their last six games, St. Louis is 5-1 and scoring almost four goals per game. Plus, the team owns a power play operating at 27.8% in that stretch as well.
Hedman now in the corner picks it up. He tried to move it around, and it bounces right out in front for Nick Paul. That one took a lightning bounce for sure, and they'll take it. 1-0 Tampa Bay. Turned over to McDonald.
Eklund scores on the 2-on-1, and the Sharks tie it.
McDonald, good turnover in the neutral zone, jumps on this, gets his head up, palms that puck down, and finds Eklund driving to the right side.
Tampa Bay has scored the third most third period goals in the NHL. The Sharks have allowed the most third period goals in the NHL. Stamkos into Kucherov, rebound, scores! Brayden Point does it again! And the Lightning retake the lead, 2-1. Point dancing in, wide open, it's Duclair in, scores! What a goal by Anthony Duclair! 3-1 Tampa Bay! Excellent finish to hit the 20-goal mark. Most of them this season obviously scored with the San Jose Sharks, but he makes a triumphant return. In comes Kucherov now to try to pull that one out. He does the point, scores! What a play by Kucherov again! From his knees, sets up points, and it is 4-1. And that is goal number 40 for Brayden Point, back-to-back two-goal games. Another shot, one more save by Andre Vasilevsky, and that is it. The Tampa Bay Lightning have won 5 in a row, and the amazing season of Nikita Kucherov continues with another four-point game.
Coming up, the Jets are trying to chase down the Canucks for the number one seed in the West. Stick around and see if we have a new team atop the conference when On the Fly returns after the break. Welcome back to On the Fly. Let's head out to the Prudential Center where the Devils hosted the Central Division leading Jets.
Now turning is Connor, but his pass goes to Meyer, and he'll flip it ahead. Just onside, he's stopped by Brossoit. Nico Hischier in all alone, and the game's best save right there.
Back the other way by Toffoli, 2-on-1 with Ehlers. Comes to Ehlers in front, and Allen denies him. So both goalies don't see a puck for the opening 5 minutes, and then have to stop breakaways. So the Devils will get their first power play of the game.
It's a big spot in the game here.
Luke Hughes shoots, deflected, rebound. Jack Hughes scores!
There's an opening there, short side of the right pad of the goaltender Brossoit, and Devils score a power play goal.
Luke Hughes getting the assist on Jack Hughes' goal. Here's Scheifele finding the trailer. Oh, Allen makes the save on Morrissey, and it's sat underneath his pad.
He didn't know where it was. It was in front of him. He was looking to the left, and Brendan Smith quickly got it out of harm's way. But that was a great save, but he had no idea after the save that puck was right in front of him sitting there.
Now here's a chance for Ehlers, and he shoots and scores. Ehlers flying up the ice, rips it past Allen, and we're tied at one.
You got four guys on the ice still after a minute and a half, absolutely gassed. It's like they're standing still as Fly comes through the middle of the ice at 100 miles an hour. Look at him, eyes up from forehand to backhand. Look at the time, space, and he just beats Allen low.
And the Devils will go to the power play for the third time. The
Devils trying to get their lead back with the man advantage.
Devils first unit's been out there the whole time. Right to the front.
Nice touch there, tips it past Brossoit to give the Devils a 2-1 lead. Luke Hughes gets tripped up by Barron, power play Devils.
Jack Hughes comes high slot, he wrists one on, he scores! A fair power play goal tonight! Jack does it again!
Now this looks like vintage New Jersey Devils. When you don't have a lot of lanes, just get the puck to the net.
Brossoit does come out of his net, so the Winnipeg goal is empty. Ahead to Timo Meier, gaping net! Meyer backhands, he scores! Timo Meyer seals it!
This, for me right now, guys, best game all year.
Two-man advantage for the Canucks for over a minute.
Quinn Hughes. Pettersson in front. Miller, the tip, and Montembeau, the right pad was ready.
Here comes Suzuki. Lindholm trying to play defense. Suzuki, Gallagher, stopped by the Smith. A deep to the backing, and the Smith got the blocker up to keep it 0-0. As McCabe sweeps the puck back to Zadorov, long shot, score! Lafferty with the disturbance in front, allowing Zadorov to score from long range, and it's 1-0. 47th time they got the first goal of the game this season. As the Canucks break in, here's a pass across. Zadorov shoots, he scores, his second of the period. Second career multi-goal game for Nikita Zadorov.
I don't know if you had it in your bingo card, Craig, but Zadorov with two in the first period for the Canucks. Second period underway.
He's checked by Alex Newhook, who makes a move towards goal. Centers. Smith with the right pad, just stoned Joel Armia. Caulfield into the faceoff circle, centers, right toe save by Casey to Smith off Alex Newhook. Garland busting up the middle, hoping for a pass, he's got it. Connor Garland shoots, he scores. Connor Garland posting in, and it's 3-0 Vancouver.
Canucks a critical three-goal lead here.
Goals in back-to-back games for Connor Garland.
Second period, 3-0 Canucks. Caulfield waits, wrist shot, tip, score! Tipped in front, Juraj Slafkovský, point streak alive. Still a teenager, he'll turn 20 at the end of the month. It's been a pleasure to watch the development.
A player that maybe was a little late to get to what he's going to be and started to make really good strides.
Nils Åman has just scored, and his goal drought is done. He gets his first in 23 as he tips home a shot from Tyler Myers. 4-1 Canucks. The Canucks win another one on this homestand, 4-1 over Montreal, and increase their lead in the Western Conference to 3 points as they win by 3.
The second time, Leo versus Connor.
Good words being said there between Connor Bedard and Leo Carlson.
Jones now in deep to the crease. Puck loose. Bedard tried to backhand it in.
He got away from Carlson, who was one-on-one on him.
Wraparound denied by Dostal.
Fourth shot on goal for Connor Bedard.
The centering pass, McTavish for Petrano. Big save, Soderblom. Puck loose off the goal line. Tyler Johnson taken down. That's a penalty on Anaheim.
Now we got tempers flaring.
No score after one period of play.
Understand why you go there.
Gus Lindstrom with a shot that's tipped in. And Anaheim strikes first.
Killorn his ninth goal in the last 19 games. That's a real nice pace. Leeson into the Chicago zone. He scores! Use the defenseman as a screen. Pulls it in. It's 2-0.
4-on-4 it is. Jones keeps it in. And Carlson is injured.
Boy, they went leg on leg. And Carlson took the worst of it.
Duck still working the Chicago zone. The open man is Killorn, and he scores. Second of the game for Alex Killorn.
We got a scrap right here. Here's Stroman, Vlasic, and you know why they're fighting. There was no intent by Vlasic, but you're the Anaheim Ducks. I mean, you've got an injured player.
Half a minute of the two-man advantage. Petrano has time. He scores! He had gone 9 games without a goal before tonight. Lukas Dostal has his first career NHL shutout.
Good team win tonight.
It is time now for the Top Shelf Plays of the Night.
He has found a roll. Oh, a turnover by Harrison.
Hey, saved by Harrison. He robs Lemieux, who is pretty much counting that one. Sam Harrison makes the mistake in the giveaway and then makes up for it in a big way.
To spring Nyquist. Comes across the line. O'Reilly on his right. Such a pass. Oh, what a save. Bob Bobrovsky kicks the left pad out and steals one away from O'Reilly. You're not going to see a better save than that.
The two friends coming in, Burns has it to Jarvis. Score!
Oh, maybe the elder statesman and his protege team up to win this thing.
And the 2-on-1 by Burns and Jarvis hands it.
Leeson in the Chicago zone. He scores! Use the defenseman as a screen, pulls it in.
Boy, that was beautiful. He pulled the string on that. Watch him pull that puck into his wheelhouse and just snap it right through the legs of the defenseman.
David triggers a 2-on-1. And pulls it to Vander Kane. And pulls it. Chance!
This is NHL Network.
It is time now for your three stars of the night. Our third star is Matthias Ekholm, who recorded 3 points in the Oilers' 8-3 win over the Sabres. Second star, Jonathan Quick, earned career win number 391, tying him for most by an American-born goaltender. And our first star is Kevin Lankinen, who recorded his first shutout of the season in the Predators' 3-0 win over the Panthers. And I'll say our fourth star, just adding this here, is, you know, Mike Kelly joins us again. So, Mike, listen, in honor of March Madness and the NCAA tournament being in full bloom, we decided to break out our NHL brackets on ice. And here are the rules because we need them. Single game elimination. So, yes, this is not what you will see when the playoffs start, but it'll be fun. Seeds are 1-8 for each conference. The better seed gets the home game until we hit the finals and go to a neutral site again. Remember, these seeds are entering Thursday. Kells, I hope you wrote all that down. I hope you have that in your brain and you're ready to rock because you're up first. How are you breaking down your bracket?
I'm breaking it down in the way that it's going to play out accurately, and I will predict all of the right matchups here.
Wow.
Probably not, but we'll give it a whirl. Look, Boston over Detroit, easy for me. Carolina, they're a wagon. Tampa Bay in a one game? Hey, we saw what they did against the Rangers recently, big comeback win. I think they could do it in a one gamer. And Florida. So then I got Carolina, Florida in the East final. We'll tell you who's going to the Cup final in a minute, but in the West, give me Vegas over Vancouver in a one-gamer. Come on, that Stanley Cup pedigree. Edmonton over Dallas. Colorado's going through. Winnipeg's going through. Some people don't think the Jets are the real deal. Guess what? I do. I got them up against Edmonton in the West Final. Who will play for the Stanley Cup? We'll find out as soon as we hear your picks.
I like what you did there. You went with Vegas there. But we now throw my picks up on the board, and here we go, because these are the ones that are going to happen. I'm sorry, Kels. Like, yours were nice. Mine are correct. Bruins, yes. Canes, yes. The Rangers are going to beat the Lightning in this one game. You know, the Rangers are 7-2-1 in their last 10 against Tampa Bay, and there's that Breadman guy that I just love to be able to talk about. I'm going to take the Panthers as well. Go to the other side of things, and Vancouver is going to beat the Golden Knights. Sorry. You've got Edmonton knocking off Dallas. Colorado, I love them. The Jets, I'm a fan of them as well. And then you see where we're at there with the Canes and the Panthers. And then we're going to end up with the Canucks and the Avalanche. And we're going to be vying to see who goes to the finals. So that's the correct bracket for now. Now you can go with your fun one. Go ahead. Have some fun.
And look, I'm just going to skip right to the punchline here. The Stanley Cup's coming back to Canada. And the Winnipeg Jets are going to win it.
Wow.
They're going to beat the Florida Panthers in the Stanley Cup final. This is one of the best defensive teams in the NHL. They got Connor Hellebuck. He's going to win the Vezina Trophy. Fly the Stanley Cup up to Winnipeg.
So the Panthers are going to lose in the Cup final. Back-to-back years. Listen, typically when teams get there, they don't get back. But I'm going to say the Panthers will get back there. And who are they facing? The Avalanche and the Florida Panthers are your champs in the one-game battle. You don't like my pick, do you?
No, I'd love to see Florida win it.
Okay. All right, there we go.
They just won't, because Winnipeg will, because I said they would.
All right, so listen, as it stands right now, Winnipeg and Florida, all our fans out there, you love us. All right, that's going to do it for us. From Mike Kelly and our entire crew, I am Keith Irizarry. We will catch you next time.
The month of March is coming to an end here, and every game counts so much.
You're not going to see a better save than that.
Oh, that's a spirited tilt down here in South Florida to start it off.
He scores! What a roll! It's a hat trick! Oh, baby, what a night.